G'day, and welcome to Propmaker. This is the channel that helps you make stuff, restore stuff, and repair stuff. And today, behind me, we've just been dropped around a friend's pinball machine. Are you feeling lucky? This one's called Lucky Seven from Williams. Roll the thing. So what do we got? Well, I looked up on IPDB, the old brochure, and it says Solid State Lucky 7, a distinctive pinball experience from Williams. Lucky 7 is Williams' electronic, new, exciting, solid-state four-player game with a super-designed playfield and action-packed features. Pinball, wizards, and novices worldwide, young and old, quickly we'll discover the thrill of playing Lucky 7. With a playfield that's a visual delight, Lucky 7 invites and entices player participation. Top and bottom rollovers, drop advanced targets, match center targets, spinning lanes, and more. Lucky 7 is the only game on the market to feature a lineup of three colorful spinning reel symbols on the playfield. Freewheeling action, big scoring opportunities for bonus and double bonus points, extra ball, and an industry-leading check system, all a part of this great new game from Williams. We're with you every step of the way. All right, so as I said, this has just been dropped around. Actually, it came probably a couple of months ago, probably maybe even closer to 4 or 5 months ago, and it's been sitting in my living room next to my couch ever since. I just haven't had a chance with all my machines and also doing some home renovation stuff. So I left this as grimy as and untidy as it came out of my mate's shed and into my living room. So all the dust is still here. What we probably need to do before we do anything, and that's just make sure that during its transport, and it did get here on the back of a ute, and it came head attached. They didn't detach anything, so I am a bit concerned about what might have rattled loose or anything like under this playfield, as other YouTubers in this pinball game have always told you. Make sure that you check things out before you plug it in, otherwise it could lead to catastrophe or even danger. So I did actually, prior to this video, try to take this glass off and it seems to be a bit stuck. So we're going to try and get the glass off, have a closer look at this playfield. I've taken some B-roll of the playfield as it is, which I'll be probably showing you right now. And there's lots of ball swirls, there's lots of dust and grime. The back glass though looks really good. There's only a couple of nicks and a couple of scratches, but that looks vibrant as and as good as you could probably get for something that's circa 1978. Just actually having a look back at the stats on this thing, if I can get back out of this. So let's get a look at some stats. Right, so Lucky 7, it came out in January 19, 1978. It's a Williams System 3 pinball machine. And there was only 4,253 units made, according to this, that has been confirmed. What are the stats we got here? It's got two flippers, two pop bumpers, two slingshots, drop targets, also two. Stand-up targets, there are five. Some playfield animation and a slot machine reels that sit right here in the center of the game, which I'm guessing act like a slot machine, which is pretty cool, and I'm pretty excited to get that up and running so I can see how that works. The scores the displays. They actually have 6 digits. So this is between the System 3 and System 6. This is actually System 3, and they all had 6-digit displays. System 7 went to 7 digits in their displays. It was designed by Chris Otis, and the art was by Christian March, or Marche. And the software was by Ron Krauss. There was an EM version of this game in 1977. So, yes, this is definitely not the EM version as far as I can tell, because I had a look in behind that glass, and it does remarkably look like, very similar to my Time Warp. All right, well, I'm going to try and get this glass off, and we'll see if we can take it from there. Let me first take this door open, take the back, a lock bar off. And I'm just going to put that back in place. It's a nice smell of old dust, anyway. Oh, looks like we've got this moving a little bit. Gotcha. Sometimes these can be stuck fast, and you have to either put some sort of cleaning liquid, maybe sort of squirt it down the side of these seams and just let it soak in for a bit. I've seen other people just try and wiggle it and jostle it so that it gets a little bit of a gap up there, and then they get some grabbers in behind it and start pulling it out. This one, I was lucky, used the old hand method, which is just clean a little bit of the glass, put your hands flat and try and drag as hard as you can. That seemed to work. But grab this phone. You can see how grubby this this glass is. Also, the feet on this didn't come with any feet at all on the legs. So it was one of the first things that I bought. I haven't put those on yet. I thought I'll wait till I actually get it so I can pull it out from the wall and get the feet on. And I'll do that one at a time at some point. Never ever rest glass straight onto concrete. This is tempered glass, which means that if it gets a real temperature shock sitting or resting straight onto concrete, it'll just shatter, it'll just explode. So don't ever do that. I've got a wooden floor here, and also I've got a nice drop sheet underneath this, which is what this is resting on. So it's a little tip. So let's have a look at this playfield in a bit more detail. So what have we got? Look at this playfield. It's actually looking pretty good. Yeah, I'm just thinking this is actually pretty tidy. There's a lot of grime to clean, and broken rubbers and old rubbers that look a bit worse for the wear. That spinner looks pretty good. Other side's a bit worn, but you know, it does get hit by a lot, these spinners. Especially if you're a good player. And here's this reel slot machine. This reel feature with three reels in at the bottom is looking pretty good. We've got targets. It's a drop target. It's another drop target down here, but that's actually down. Another target up there. It's actually looking pretty nice. And should clean up well. It's a little bit of drag on the on that where it's touching. Hasn't worn the playfield yet, but you can hear it. But, look at maybe just making sure that that's set correctly. Look at her. How grubby is she looking? Well, the same with her. She's got maybe a tiny little plank, a bit of planking, but she's looking pretty good. The surface feels pretty good, just apart from the dirt and grime. Up here, it does feel like the paint would rub off. So I think I'll be careful around there when I'm cleaning. But apart from that, that's looking pretty nice. I'll get up close to this back glass. As you can see, there's a couple of bits where things are worn, but Peter, who owns this game, likes old patina, so there won't be anything done to that. It'll just be basically wiped clean so the dust is off it, but that's about it. Let's see if we can get above this. This dusty. It all looks pretty good though. This button looks pretty worn. It's seen a few games. Pretty dusty. So, let's see about lifting this up. I'll set you down for a sec. Now, I've got a bunch of stuff I've already bought for this machine. Well, let's first have a look at this, the ball that came out of it. Maybe I can refocus. This ball's a bit rusty. Yes. So a new pinball actually headed for this game. What have we got inside here? So I'll go through that stuff in a minute, because the stuff I've been shoving in here in preparation for doing a bit of a clean up. So we've got a fairly tidy box. You can see that there's still chimes used in this game. So they're still from the EM era, still being used, but there's four chimes. So two banks, one with three, one with one chime in it, and that's pretty cool. The underneath of the playfield is actually looking really, really clean. Ten fuse amp. It's actually looking really good. Nothing looks out of the ordinary. And these coils all look pretty good. Yeah. there's those reels. You can see they actually look pretty grimy. And I think they're just paper. So I have to be pretty careful about how we clean those up a bit. May not really even need to. There is a piece of plastic perspex that actually covers them, and this one's intact. I saw Ronnie on Joe's Classic Video Games channel repairing one, and they had one come in and they didn't have that plastic bit, so can't recall what they actually did to fix that, but I'm lucky, so I don't need to actually replace any of that. It's actually looking really good. This, we might be lucky in just doing a clean up, turn on, make sure all the fuses are right and all that. Just looking at the cabinet, cabling looks fine. Nothing looks out of the ordinary. Nothing looks like it's got metal. Oh, down here. This looks like someone's replaced some coils at some point. Not two of those sitting here, probably more. No. Coin door and everything, coin hopper, it's all still there. Well, looks like we've got some damage here. What's this? A bit of cabinet has come off from somewhere. So if we're lucky to identify where that came from, I'll probably glue that back in place. Seeing as it looks like it's still got good paint on it and everything, so yeah. This looks fine. So it's probably from one of the corners or one of the edges. I've got, this is our knocker. That's what I assume is what knocks against the board when we match score at the end of a game. We have our plumb bob doesn't seem to be connected to anything, so that's not probably a great thing, but luckily someone had the foresight to just drop that into there and just leave it there, and it survived a ute ride on the back of a truck all the way here. This fuse looks fine to me. There's another fuse over here. It's looking good. Now let's see what goodies we've got at the back here. I do have my little list of things. But Pete was able to find the original manual, the original instruction manual, which is pretty amazing. So it has sort of the basics in here, and the dip switch settings and all sorts of stuff that's going to be useful in repairing and restoring this. And as far as I know, Pete said this wasn't operating. I don't know, I haven't actually switched it on yet. So I've bought some things already, and also in case I didn't actually have it, I actually printed out my own copy of the manual. And I also printed out whatever schematics I could find on the System 3. So that's here for me. And I bought some things. So I've got a new ball in there. Some rubbers. You should actually have pretty much all the rubbers. Things like the plunger, shooter springs, and even the outside spring for the shooter. And a couple more rubbers that were missing, so that's fine. And I also bought four new feet off Rusty. So that's cool. Let's see what else is actually in here, because I'm seeing. Let's open this door up. Put that over there. I took the coin hopper lid off, and what did I find in here? Coins! And also in here I found the Commercial Bank of Australia Limited silver $10 in coins. I think that bag would be worth selling. Peter, I think you should get this appraised. Anyway, it's pretty rare. What else have we got inside this bag? So inside this bag, we've got a whole bunch of really cool things. Got our scorecards. For different scoring methods. A card advising when you'll get one replay. And we have another instruction card, which actually has both, or a couple of different methods of play. So they're all pretty cool. So I'm going to put them back in Pete's expensive bag here. I'll do that carefully. Safe and sound. I'll leave that in here. What have we got? One, two, three. About $3 worth of change. That's fantastic. And lifting up this tray, I found the plumb bob. This is the plumb bob. Wow, so that will hang there and there, and that means plumb bob is complete for the tilt. There is no tilt ball in here, so I'll need to get one of those. So it looks like this thing just overheated, so I'm going to continue on the iPhone. But I just noticed something. If you look down here, looks like the ground cable or the earth braid is not connected to the top box, so that's probably not a good thing. That's a good reason why it definitely wouldn't work. What's that under there? Bit of polystyrene. But apart from that, everything else is actually looking pretty good under here. There's a bit more polystyrene in this box here. I wonder what that box is actually for. It says Australia, £2. So I'm guessing it's a resonator box or a resonation box of some sort to make the chimes louder. Or maybe even softer. I don't know, I'm gonna have to look that up. But there's these plastic boxes under here that allow the chimes to I guess resonate differently than what they would normally if they weren't there. Alright, I'm going to hook that earth cable back up once this back glass is actually off, and we can actually have a look in here. So looking at this back glass with this glass now off and out, this glass actually looks beautiful. Absolutely happy with that. We'll have a closer look at that a little bit later, but having a look in here, it's very clean. Just a bit of dust. The displays look good. They all look practically new. A few bulbs that look a bit wonky here and a bit blown, but that's all right. So let's open up this and have a look in here. Yep. So that earthing braid should be connected to this, and it's not. So that's definitely something that we can remedy straight away. I'm not seeing any damage from these batteries. I don't know how long these batteries have been in here, but it looks like they have been jostled around. Let's see if we can zoom in on those. Yeah. These batteries don't look the greatest, so I'll probably rip them straight out. Everything's looking pretty good in here though. So these fuses I'll probably look at. This one definitely looks blown though. This one over to the side here. And these, yeah, there's definitely a blown fuse in the middle of that one. So we've got to figure out why they blew. Just make sure everything's connected. Looking at the connectors, they look pretty tidy. This one's interesting. We have a whole bunch of cut wires off this connector here. So a lot of wires have been severed there. I'm assuming they were these wires here, because they seem to be the same colour. They're all yellow, so that means they're general illumination. And they've now been put down here, maybe. I don't know. I'll have to investigate further. We'll get to the bottom of it when we look at the schematic. Anyways, we will learn. Everything, yeah, looks pretty tidy. I did find one of these tip 102s down in the bottom of the box, but they look like they're all there. So I'd say one of them's been replaced. And look here, on this power supply, someone's actually hard wired this wire, the red and white, straight onto this fuse holder. And there's no fuse in here. And it looks like it's gone through a bit of damage. It's heated up and burned that board a bit, so you need to take that off and have a look at it. So it'll be a while before we actually turn this on. I think I need to do a little bit of investigation work before we can get to that point. But all the original stickers and charts all look pretty good. Look, everything looks fine. Danger, high voltage. There's another card down there, probably with a serial number on it. So we get a better view of that. Now it's a bit dark. All right. Might get it with the iPhone. All right, but that's looking pretty good. For the starting video of Lucky Seven, and just looking at this glass again, let's have a quick look at the back. There's a few cracks and stuff in the paint, but nothing too major. It's actually really good nick, and pretty happy with the way that actually is at the start of this reno. And when we're talking about this renovation, we'll say that he doesn't want to disturb the patina. He wants it to still remain old. He didn't want me to touch that paintwork. All I did say though is I will clean this up. These ball swells can actually continue to damage the game, so it's always best to give this a good clean, rip all this stuff up, make sure it's all fine, make sure all the lamps are working, and then give it a good wax, replace all the rubbers, put everything back together. It's going to be good. All right. So that looks like the start of this renovation on Lucky Seven. So then in the next bit, I'll start working methodically through these issues. I do, first of all, want to get to the bottom of this wire here on the power supply, and also just run some checks on the driver board and the MPU. Everything else is looking good. I'll probably test and replace all the fuses and try and take note of which fuses seem to be busted and try and figure out why some of these wires have been cut and moved. I'd say it's because that fuse holder has wrecked that rail somehow by burning up. Anyway, it should be a fun renovation.
We'll be right back.
Okay, so that's where we're going to leave it today. We cleaned the play field and got rid of all those ball swirls and all of the grime and muck out of this completely, and now it's looking a million bucks. As you can see, I've removed the power supply board, which I'm just looking over now, but that'll probably be the next video where we're going to go through and recap that power supply board, make sure that all the soldering joints are okay, and then we'll get stuck into each of the other boards. And I don't think it'll actually be too long before this is up and running, touch wood, but it's looking pretty good. So I'll give you a quick look over how this is looking now on the playfield, and until next time, like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one on this Lucky 7 restoration. You've been listening to Propmaker. Roll the thing.